corporate establishment media is now starting to cover all these fake beheading videos that are being put out by ISIS. I'm not saying ISIS isn't murdering people and chopping their heads off and throwing folks off roofs and bombing churches. That's going on. But these highly produced videos we've seen being put out by the Free Syrian Army, Al-Qaeda, ISIS, ISIL, whatever the new name to divert the public is of the week. Now a video has surfaced of the soundstage shooting of one of these beheadings, and either it is real, that is real footage of the staging, or whoever staged the filming deserves an Oscar for recreating the other fake videos. Because you can see that it's fake green screen desert scenes, and the way it's shot is so iconic. Anyone with a cinematic eye can see this is more real than real. That is, it doesn't look fake. It looks over the top real. The one shot out of a million. And then all these 7-foot men marching 5-foot people to the sea to have their heads chopped off as well. Computer programmed, fake. We're going to be going over some of this today. I wrote about it. Paul Watson wrote about it a decade ago. That you would have people like Adam Gadon from the United States arrested for beating up Muslims outside their mosque. Grandfather, former head of the ADL. He's arrested for his anti-Muslim activities repeatedly. Next, he pops up, the number three guy in Al-Qaeda, leading jihadist. And then, of course, the videos he's uploaded are being uploaded in the same video layer as the Pentagon's directed intel center. And even Wired magazine at the time did a video analysis and said, this is fake. That is, it was uploaded in the same video layer with the Al-Qaeda bug as the Pentagon bug. So that's how stupid they think we are. That video is up on Infowars.com. What this shows is Western intelligence and others, I mean, we know who's funding ISIS. Turkish intelligence, Saudi Arabian intelligence, NATO. That's all come out in the news. They've got propaganda corps out there. Whereas this looks horrible to you and I in the West, it looks barbarous. This recruits all the real nuts thinking this is just beautiful. I'll use the allegory, the parallel, the analogy of a rotting dead horse. Now, a rotting dead horse stinks and looks really disgusting, covered in maggots, to you or I, because we're omnivores that like to eat fresh things, strawberries, fresh meat, grains, milk. We like tasty things that are clean. We're not designed to eat rotten things. But to a gaggle of buzzards or a big old gobbin, a big murder of buzzards, that's the term for a whole large group of birds. If it's a carrion bird, is a murder. I guess that started with crows back in the Middle Ages, but it extends. So if you got a couple hundred buzzards or, let's say, vultures, they see a big old rotten dead horse. That looks like pumpkin pie to them. It looks like tapioca pudding. And so they put out this stink bait for the craziest jihadis in the world. They come scurrying, they let them fly wherever they want, they let money get raised to build the army of scum. And that's now what's been turned loose. That's a little side issue. We're going to be getting into that today. There is so much news out there. The drug lord that we mentioned yesterday on the Sunday show, who escaped, he's now challenging Donald Trump as the clowning only intensifies here in Circus of the Americas. It's already the 13th day of July on this Monday worldwide broadcast. I am your host, Alex Jones. And we're going to premiere and play a lot of special reports here today across the political spectrum from different angles and from around the world. And we are going to also open the phones up. It is a very heavy news day, to say the least. And I will attempt to cover it all. That said, last night and again this morning, I was brainstorming about ways to reach out to the general public and to try to break them out of their trance. And it really hit me that it's parables, or basically simple stories, historically, that are able to get people to shift out of unconsciousness into at least a mode of being somewhat focused on the big picture. And I've talked a lot about this pretty much ad nauseum, but it crystallized that we need to form some type of movement. We need to form some type of pro-human union around the world that transcends the divide and conquer that we're under attack by. And I was really thinking about this last night when I went to bed at like 10 o'clock. And then again, when I woke up this morning and I went downstairs into the kitchen, turned on the computer, started drinking some coffee, and sat back for about 25 minutes watching a video and reading an article that Paul Watson had just posted to Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com, and watching the video and then thinking about other statements I've seen out of Russian leaders. It was incredible. And it just crystallized everything I already knew, but made it so clear that it almost took a giant weight off of me. And then I realized how exhausted I was. This understanding was so simple, but at the same time, so complex. That I realize I never really talk about it or get into it because it's something so important it needs to be put in a pamphlet or a book. It needs to be promoted. It needs to be released with fanfare because it really is the decoding of everything we face and the choice of the species. Because if I just sit here and spew this information out like a broken fire hydrant onto a boiling August day, or in this case, a July day, the information just kind of evaporates up into the sky in this desert of ignorance. Yeah, maybe a few open minds come and cool off in the water for a few minutes, but sure enough, the New World Order Fire Department comes along and we'll just fix the leak and, you know, shove it full of a bunch of Beyonce says ban the First Amendment and Hillary says men need to be sent to re-education fund camps and the Pentagon's training to put Tea Partiers in, quote, re-education camps. And we've got more deaths from Gardasil around the world. Just this background that is the wreckage of the ship of tyranny, the ship of death, the ship of corruption, the ship of fraud, the ship that is willing to overturn our world and everything good in it, because everything good in it is diametrically opposed to the hellish vision of the controllers. And that's why it's hard to break this down, because I get inside their mind, I get inside their future plans, their current operations, their past plans, understanding their worldview, understanding where they're going, understanding the crazed spirit of conquest that fills their sails. I know one thing for certain. No one should be bored right now. No one should be saying their life is meaningless. When consciousness on this planet and all that comes with it itself is a limitless, pristine, godlike, opportunity. Because every day I come in here and every night and every morning I read all these news articles and all these video clips and all these interesting factoids and things I want to cover and things that can be used to get folks to see a wider vista, a wider horizon. But if you just look at it individually overall, it becomes clutter that sits in front of the mind and blocks out the light of the wider world coming into the cave. To use the allegory of the third eye, it's a bunch of piled up, wrecked, twisted droppings, leavings of the train wreck that we're witnessing. And we simply need to understand that we're not going to defeat this system coming at it from its level. We're going to have to circumnavigate it. We're going to have to get outside of it. We're going to have to remove ourselves from it at afar to observe it. Or the classical statement, get outside the box. And that's why everything we face in this world, everything pushed by the social engineers, is there to keep us shuttered, dumbed down, simple-minded, with limited language and limited semantical symbols, unable to communicate with each other at a bestial, dumbed-down level. Because above that outside the box, there is less than 1/1,000th of 1% that are evil and who are aware of what's going on, who are outside the box and have said, oh my gosh, we are enlightened, we are informed, we are illuminated, we know what's going on. We can't let them inside the box know what's going on outside the box. In fact, they could find a way out of the subterranean labyrinth and emerge to the surface if we don't wall off all the exits and try to dig them deeper under the ground, under level after level after level of rat mazes, so that they can sit back and play God over the rest of us. You see the globalists funding radical Islamicists to destabilize and take down countries. You see them going into any nation that's trying to industrialize and bringing them down. You see them maneuvering the United States towards financial collapse and setting us up to only be a military power so that we can be the muscle of the globalist, but controlled by baubles and industrial goods and energy. Other countries under the treaties, the globalist agreements, are not supposed to have big militaries, but then they are allowed to have the industry, the jobs, the factories, because they are totalitarian. They will then use the totalitarianism as a form of competition to force us to convert to totalitarianism in the name of competing. The only way to compete in a globalized world is become more globalized. And then that means adopting whatever the high priest of the global order say it is that particular month, that particular year, that particular decade. And when one reads the writings of the globalist, it only becomes more hellish. But here's the big announcement. And it's something you've heard about before, but I really want to focus it, condense it, and hammer it, and develop plans with you to try to reach out to others in a catchy way, because this is catchy. This is dynamite information. This is the key. To try to shift people out of their swamp, their trance that they're in. And the bottom line is this. All fighting between humans, whether it be Christian against Muslim, or whether it be Mexican against somebody in the U.S., or whether it be Protestant versus Catholic, or one black tribe against another black tribe, all of it in the end is being artificially exacerbated so that humanity is so fragmented that the scientific takeover can take place and end humanity as we know it. Now I understand you already know that, but that's a big idea. And we come back, I want to break down the fact that Russia, the United States, Libya, Germany, Mexico, Chile, Japan, doesn't matter where you live, what continent or what country, we're all under the exact same globalist attack. It's just this. If you read the hundreds of books and thousands of white papers that are out there admitting this plan, we have a technological elite that Eisenhower talked about in control of the military-industrial complex, backed by the robber barons of the 18th and 19th century, who are in a race to become gods and merge with machines. They're setting up a planetary government designed to bankrupt sovereign and self-sufficient nations and individuals. Every policy is to end family. Every policy is to end local farming and ranching and sustainable communities, which they claim they're promoting. We want to give you affordable health care, doubles, triples prices. We want sustainability. Everything they do is kill sustainability. Whether you're in Australia or the U.S. or Canada or Germany, they will try to fine you and harass you if you have your own wind farm or your own electrical power, your own solar. They want you wired into the grid. And they're admitting all of this now. And so what we see being done to Russia, the attack on the family, the attack on their sovereignty, the tariffs, the sanctions. What do you think NAFTA and GATT were to the U.S.? They were sanctions to distribute the wealth to totalitarian countries the globalists controlled. And it doesn't mean that Russia is run by even wonderful people, but they are nationalistic and they do care about their heritage and they are trying to boost their population. And they're talking on state-run television over there about how roundtable groups have taken the U.S. over and taken over Europe, and how they've already hired 1,000 covert Russians in positions of power who will then get part of the power once they overthrow the Russian Federation. And they talk about the Rothschilds and the Rockefellers and how Putin arrested all their heads, and it turned out the oligarchs were just their front men. And this even came out in British court. The Rothschilds sued British newspapers 6 years ago who were reporting this. And the judge said in the case, turns out this trial proves it's true. And they've got the Vatican completely captured. Whether the Vatican was good or bad before is a moot point now. The Vatican is promoting planetary government, carbon taxes, and a tax on the family, and backing off abortion. Major Protestant churches across the board are now doing the same thing. This is the day of planetary government. And understand, it's not planetary government to bring in peace, to bring in a new age of happiness. It brings in absolute death. And we just have to get the quotes, the facts, the statements, put it together in well-done films with graphics and animations. We need to put out books that just explain the real history of the world and its future. I mean, it's the Book of Secrets. It's the new keys to Solomon. You can call it whatever you want. It's hiding in plain view. We seem to be the only ones that understand the full spectrum and are saying it. And let me tell you, that's a scary feeling. Because I know I'm 100% right. And I know that their battle plan is ongoing. And it will destroy all of us. I don't care if you live in Chile, or whether you live in Canada, or whether you live in Russia, or whether you live in South Africa, or whether you live in Nigeria, or whether you live in Iraq, or whether you live in Tasmania. It doesn't matter where you live. It is the exact same names, the same bureaucrats, the same bureaucracies, the same taxes, the same regulations, the same spy tech built into everything to allow globalist and their Skynet program. That's what they call the satellite directing drones program in the 70s. See, they didn't get that from Terminator. Terminator got it from them. And Skynet is now being announced. Autonomous robots, ground, air, and sea, and undersea. Here's just the Wall Street Journal today. Smart cities will know everything about you, Wall Street Journal, and how governments are financing and supporting everything going to this. They just throw it in your face. Here's one I mentioned yesterday that I'm going to get to today. Cheer up, the post-human era is dawning. Better than Friends, AP, the robot gives undivided attention. It isn't like this is just all the evolution of things. This is the evolution that's been chosen. So when I see people on Infowars.com or YouTube, racist white people making racist comments, racist black people making comments, all of you, racist Mexicans making comments, you're idiots.
We're on the march.
We're under attack. All of us dumbasses.
Alex,
I will knock your freaking teeth out if you don't wake up. One reason we've got a leg up on the globalist is a lot of patriots inside government, major corporations in the last 60 years since this plan began to go public in the councils of government. After this eugenics plan began to leak in the late 50s, there was major opposition to it. But there's been parallel recruiting programs going on where they tell people, you'll be taken care of once this world government goes into place. And the big secret is, no, you won't be taken care of, because when you dig deeper into the globalist admissions, they plan to exterminate at least 90% of the public. And they're going to do it by releasing soft-kill pathogens, chemical, biological, radiological, magnetic, frequency-based as well, which is radiation, it's another class, into the environment, and then they've got everything set up and structured through centralized computers that the doctors are only allowed to go off diagnoses issued by the diagnostic computers and only allowed to get treatment under the diagnostic directives, to where they're not even ever able to discover what's killing you. And that's why they can't have an independent India or an independent Nigeria or an independent Vatican or an independent CDC or an independent Russia, governments, institutions, or independent doctors in the U.S. Air Force. All these examples I just mentioned are where the Russian government, Air Force high-level doctors, Nigerian top doctors, Indian top doctors. There's been thousands of cases that I know of in my 20 years on air where scientists go public and go, I was brought in at the GMO conference, and they admitted that, yes, this potato that we're designing will sterilize people, but that we're to cover it up because there's too many people, and I'm not going to be part of it. I mean, I've had these scientists on. British scientists, Pakistani scientists. Scientists go and they test the Vatican when it was a little different in the 80s and in the 90s, tested hepatitis shots, tetanus shots that they had added chemicals and hormones to cause an autoimmune event so that women could never carry a baby to term. A very vicious form of sterilization. That was mainstream news. I mean, the point is there's just all these quasi-secret programs going on that are targeting all of us, and we can see the results. The wages of being under globalism is death. We can see the cancer up multi-thousand percentage points in children up over 10,000 percentage points since the 50s. We can see the diabetes type 2 up almost 3,000% in the general public, way above that in Hispanics. Do you ever hear La Raza or Mecha or any of these Ford Foundation eugenics-based? I mean, the Ford Foundation funded Hitler, and it funds the Mexican groups. Does that tell you anything? And it's not to empower them. It's to destroy you. So while you're busy saying, let's kill Donald Trump because he hates us, And they've misrepresented even what Donald Trump said, but forget that. He's an operative, in my view. Your daughters are being shot up with stuff that reduces their fertility and gives them all sorts of links to reproductive cancers in the uterus, in the fallopian tubes, in the ovaries. You want to get paralyzed? You want to get sterilized? Knock yourself out. And I just use that as a microcosm that you're not going to hear anything out of these organizations about what GMO is designed to do or what's being added to the vaccines or the globalist plans. Because they're going to orchestrate a global cascade of meltdowns, playing us off against each other, with world government there refereeing the meltdowns as the omnipotent computerized overlords, automated overlords, while humanity is basically confused, dumbed down, put in a trance, hypnotized, drugged into oblivion, and finally euthanized. I mean, they're not just going to kill Granny. They're not just going to kill the veterans they're done with. They're not just going to put them on a no-treat list and then see if they can get away with it, which they have. And they're even going to have the same computer company that ran the death camps run the computers, doing the exact same thing, making the decision, and nobody's going to stand up for the veterans because the veterans groups are controlled as well, just like the Hispanic groups are controlled and the white groups are controlled and the black groups are controlled and the Protestants are controlled and the Catholics are controlled and all the major institutions have been bought off and taken control. And you're only talking about a few thousand leaders worldwide managing all these groups. And what's their number one mission is to get you into a group and to control you and to dumb you down and to have you only know how to fight with other fellow humans over petty stuff that doesn't exist. While your food and your water is poisoned, while your jobs are taken, while your soil is poisoned, I mean, there's giant planetary geoengineering programs going on that they admit are going on, and they just tell Congress it's classified. Just like the public still thinks, maybe 30% or so, that it's a conspiracy theory that a world government's being formed because they just sit there and deny it and deny it and deny it and deny it. Now, I'm going to do the best job I can going over this, but when I go to the comments on Infowars.com, because they're somewhat uncensored, we use one of the biggest third-party commenting things. It's not us in there. I don't have moderators anymore. We used to run our own comments, and we would then have liability if somebody said kill somebody, and I had the FBI, the Secret Service, the ATF here at my office so many times because of shills in the comments. We started using Discus, which is one of the biggest third-party comment things. You're just basically commenting in a window on another giant site when you comment on Infowars.com. So they can get the government visits and we don't. But I don't control what you say in there. We are able to go to Discus, and we've done it before. We should do a whole show on this and get IP addresses and show that there'll be a guy in there saying racist stuff, acting like he's black. There'll be another guy in there acting like he's white saying racist stuff, and it's the same group of IP addresses coming from the same area. And computer experts can look at it and say, well, that's the same IP address or that's a similar one. This is the same person. But there are some real people in there making jokes, you know, like, what's the only problem with four blacks and a Cadillac going over a cliff? A Cadillac seats five. You know, just horrible stuff. And then similar stuff back at white people. On and on and on. We're all just people is what I'm getting at. And we don't have a prayer. Yes, there's differences. Yes, everybody's got a beef with everybody else. But the point is, if we don't transcend this, and I don't mean transcend it and then lay down all our rights and turn our guns in on the backs of transcending it, that's not transcending it. That's giving over your will and being a slave. If we don't realize the computers and the robots are being rolled out in every device, in every computer, in every appliance to control us and track us, to literally enslave us, and the cars are already driverless, all the new ones already have all the driverless stuff. That's why Toyotas and German cars as well. BMWs will, oh, slam the brakes on when it's needed. And, oh, if it's a school bus and it sees it, it'll just go ahead and kill you, you know, slamming into the wall so you don't hurt the greater number. This is all being announced, that your TV's watching you, that all this is happening. And it's idiocy. And I know it's wrong to sit there and be politically correct and then see whites being attacked everywhere and it being covered up by the media and then to hear all day about how you're bad. That's designed to make you hate everybody who isn't white and to get into your group. Same thing with what blacks see being done to them. It's the same MO over and over again. Or Donald Trump comes out and says, you know, we got a lot of criminals coming in out of Latin America. And it's causing a problem. Not everybody, but a large minority of the folks coming in are basically criminal. And we're allowing them to stay here, and that's wrong. Well, that's true. But then they say in the media, Donald Trump says Hispanics are lazy and steal. Well, that's not what he said. He said Latin America is collapsing in a crime wave and people are pouring over. And then El Chapo escapes from prison for the second time because he guaranteed made payoffs. Probably didn't even escape out of the tunnels they're showing. That's all for show, in my view. And he says in his Twitter account, I'm coming to get you, Donald Trump, which is meant to make him a folk hero in Mexico and play into all that stuff. Notice it's a top drug dealer who on record works for the CIA and helps ship drugs into the U.S., probably being directed by the CIA to say this right now in this whole big theater to block out the other Republican candidates by making Donald Trump the center of the universe. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Another billionaire sneaks out and is now threatening Donald Trump, who owns casinos that are basically wedded at the hip with the big banks that launder all the drug money. I mean, these are just two mafia men in a staged event. They've probably had dinner together for all I know. I mean, this is a joke of jokes. And see, we're talking about something like this. And then it allows him to be elevated even more so he takes all the attention. So instead of it being Rand Paul, who was number one in the polls for a year up until 3 months ago, now it's, who is it? Donald Trump, as I said it would be, Jeb Bush, and then Senator Paul. And then when the diversions are over, Trump will stand down, and in to get the nomination will be Jeb Bush, and then he will stand down and be a ringer for Hillary Clinton. And then Trump can sit there and tweet that he wants to basically kick El Chapo's butt. I mean, remember, Trump is part of the WWE. World Wrestling Entertainment, or what does it stand for? I mean, this is all when kids would walk into a restaurant and see the Iron Sheik with Hulk Hogan having a beer. They went, you guys hate each other. No, they don't. And I guess we're just this stupid. I guess it's what we like, but Wall Street Journal. Smart cities will know everything about you. How can marketers cash in without becoming enemies of the people? And this is an article saying governments have allowed and encouraged everything to be tracked you do. And so now everything does listen and watch you, but people don't like televisions watching them and listening to them. So how do we let marketers cash in without folks getting upset? And the answer is, hey, it's not 1984. It's not really scary. It's really not a big deal. Yes, everything you do is tracked and watched. And yes, your laptop is watching you and listening to you. But don't worry, it's a computer doing it, so it's okay. You see, this is all being set up for the AI. And it's a war against humanity. If they want to get rid of fathers, and in every sitcom for 40 years, fathers are idiots. And if we're under all this social engineering, and what the U.S. exports is, hey, we're going to conquer Russia and teach their kids how to be gay. People email me and go, why are you against gays? Let me tell you, it isn't about, quote, gay people. It's about don't have kids. Turn off the family. This is an attack. That's why they're banning husband and wife all over the U.S. at the state and federal level. And now boy and girl is hateful. This is the end, my friend, beautiful friend, of our elaborate plans, the end. Do you understand? It's been stated in 1961 that a technological scientific elite is in control of a military-industrial complex. And that it's a severe danger. Like we have that in the speech of Eisenhower Excise, the military technological elite, corporate elite, taking control of the military-industrial complex. I want to play that in the next segment. Then I'll give the number out and take your calls in the next hour. And I know I harp on this, but we need to start calling the globalists the aliens. Because I don't believe they're actually aliens, but they are so alien from humans, from normal people that have a conscience, that want to work with others, that want a better world. They're so manipulative and so psychotic and think of themselves as a new super species in their own statements and are moving to merge with computers and transcend us and are in a love affair with AI that they believe is going to merge with them. That for all intents and purposes, this is an alien invasion. But aliens didn't come from a distant star. They didn't come from a different dimension. They didn't come from the sea floor. They're not 2,000 feet tall like that last Godzilla movie, Pacific Rim, that came out. It's on our planet with sicko psychopaths merging with machines. And whether they merge or not, or whether it's already happened, because they're about 30 years ahead of what we know that. They believe they're a new species and that we've got to be taken out, and they're building the AI that's designed from the get-go to take control of our lives and to overturn free markets and to bring in a scientific tyranny. And so you've been warned. You want to make jokes about white people and go beat them up at street corners? You want to sit around and talk about how you're getting your guns ready for the race war and you're going to kill all the blacks? You want to sit around and make jokes all day about the stupid gringos and all the rest of it while your people are having the West toxic waste dumped there and being shot up with deadly poisons and being aborted? Stop it. We are all under attack. We are all human beings. And that's why they're dividing us right now. This is a scientific program rolled out with clear super psychology systems and AI technology monitoring that can predict the future and can manipulate future outcomes. This is the great test of humanity. This is over the top, and it must stop now. You must realize that the bad feeling you've got and the concern you've got in your gut is because we're now facing the conscious rollout of pure evil. And the globalists are now on the borders of Russia, openly trying to overthrow the Russian government and openly trying to take over their society to shut off their economy and destroy them, like they've done Libya and Syria and everybody else. And they've done it to us. We are absolutely fellow travelers with the Russians. Not in the Soviet term they would use, but in the term that they are under attack by the very same globalist group that doesn't come from America. It already jumped on our face, laid eggs in us, our guts busted open, the more globalist aliens spilt out and took over the world. Our belly hatched thousands of these things. We're still half alive, bleeding to death, with our guts hanging out.
We must also be alert to the equal and opposite danger that public policy could itself become the captive of a scientific, technological elite. In the councils of government, we must guard against the acquisition of unwarranted influence, whether sought or unsought, by the military-industrial complex.
Now, today we worry about Jade Helm that started, and they go, how dare you even ask questions? That's un-American. That's a quote from the different people on Fox News, from Rick Perry, from others. You can question your government, but don't question your military. Our criminal government runs our military. We get this information from the military. They're the most patriotic group out there. Now, that said, David Knight ran in here during the break, panting. And he said, you're not covering the coup in Greece. It's coming out. They held the president overnight. It's a coup. And yes, that's in my stack. And yes, I was going to get to it. And David Knight's coming in at 8 after. And I'm glad he's not in a trance. I'm glad he's concerned. I'll be honest with you, though. starting war with Russia is really bad. The globalist overthrowing Greece because they had a no vote. We knew that was coming. Kurt Nemo wrote about it last Tuesday that there was a move for a coup. I mean, they already install leaders in Greece before and in Italy. I mean, they now install Goldman Sachs heads of Europe as the presidents. So I'm not saying it isn't important. It's just that compared to the admission that they're rolling out this takeover and that it's the end of humanity as we know it, and it's suddenly in the Wall Street Journal and the Financial Times of London in the last 24 hours, sell your family heirlooms, but can Greece raise the cash, AFP? And what happened overnight? The airports, the islands, the parks, everything will now be given not to the EU, but to the creditors, the private central banks, who already got most of it in the last few years. And they will now raise taxes on tourism, even though they have some of the highest taxes in the world. And they tell the average conservative, oh, Greece deserves it. Well, it's true they were maneuvered into big government, so they would be controlled. But you have to understand, we're in bigger debt and in deeper trouble than they are. And so folks that sit around and feel like they're elitist going, yeah, those Greeks getting what they want. Yeah, Mexico can't ever seem to get its act together. We just haven't fallen yet because they're not done using us as the world's muscle. But in the next phase, as Jimmy Carter said over the weekend, they intend to bring the United States down to nothing. They've already deindustrialized us. They're already waging war on small farmers and small independent communities under the president's rural commission that's run by the Department of Defense, who has your local plainclothes military officers in every town and city working with federal funds to move the police department and county sheriff into a building with all the free communications equipment and government software there with an army officer or an Air Force officer or a Marine. It's like the body snatchers, boys and girls. And then they intend to phase out the human, HUMET military in the next decade, and it's going all machine. All automated, all watching you with special paramilitary SWAT teams in every sector ready to be dispatched to kill you, backed up by combat robots, combat trucks, and combat drones heavily armed. And it's all just going to start rolling out in your face as the collapse happens. And they've got their re-education camps built, everything. Not trying to scare you. The attack's already on. And when I watch this 20-something minute Russian member of the Duma roll it all out, he says that. You know, the species is under attack. This is a takeover with their shadow groups. We're already under attack, but they control the media. You're not going to hear the announcements. This is the end of humanity. We're going to be extincted. The Russians, for all their corruption, are smart enough to analyze this, and they know what's happening. We'll be back. Infowars.com. Infowars Nightly News anchor David Knight, also co-host of this radio transmission, will be coming in studio. There is a soft coup. That's not the proper term. A stealth coup, because there's nothing soft about it, other than they don't have the normal, you know, everybody getting their heads blown off. There is a stealth coup, similar to the one removing Hosni Mubarak 5 years ago when he wouldn't support turning al-Qaeda loose in Libya. There is a stealth coup that's taken place. The president was held overnight. The military has basically taken control of Greece. The EU has been handed all the assets, basically, that Greece has, the bank accounts, everything of private citizens that have already paid taxes. This is the model of globalism. It is epic. It is legendary. It is stunning. It is the blueprint. This has been done in Africa. This has been done all over Latin America. And it's going to be done here. So David Knight's going to be joining us, and then I will start going to your phone calls for the balance of the transmission. There is so much I haven't gotten to yet. New Zealand HPV vaccine has done this to my child. Another paralyzed girl. That was in the trials 10 years ago that it paralyzed and killed people. It's been outlawed in Japan, outlawed in India. They are injecting in what's four different Latin American countries, including Mexico, every girl by law by the age of 12, but they start at 9. And, you know, I just wish all these fancy pants people like Robert Rodriguez, who is so racist he will not hire basically anybody, And I know multiple insiders inside who are Hispanic and are shocked by it. It's how we got the script to Machete beforehand. They went, he's loco, he's crazy, he blows up all the time, he used to be really nice, he meets at the White House constantly, he started this new network where he won't hire anybody who isn't Hispanic, which is discriminatory, but see, notice it doesn't work that way. I'll just hire anybody as long as they get the job done and are nice. I don't care if there was people with green skin on this planet that could do a good job. I'd have a bunch of green aliens walking around there. But the point is that, I mean, I wish he'd warn Hispanics not to take the damn shot. But see, no, don't do that. I mean, I want to just overturn this table and start screaming to get people's attention not to give the Gardasil to girls in Mexico, which they go, oh, to stop papilloma. 4,000 people die a year from papillomavirus in the United States, 4,000 women roughly. In Mexico, it's a couple thousand. Look up. Don't believe me. 4,000 out of 110 million. Well, no, it's 330 million here, 4,000. Something like 2,000 out of 110 million. That's one of the rarest cancers in Mexico. You got a better chance of being struck by lightning twice. Yeah, there it is. Merck's former doctor predicts that Gardasil will become the greatest medical scandal of all time. Debilitating diseases that could be attributed directly to the vaccination. Health impact news. But it doesn't matter because it's so bad it'll be covered up because it's too big to fail. See, that's the thing. My dad used to explain to me growing up in Dallas, watching the savings and loans crisis and the rest of it. He said, son, don't ever steal because we're an honorable family. But he said, if you ever do steal, don't steal small, steal big. If you steal $1 billion, they'll make you a senator. If you steal $100, they'll put you in jail. And I said, what do you mean? He goes, read this book by Zygmunt Brzezinski. And I read it, The Technotronic Era, where it's all explained. How they run the narcotics, how they run the flesh trade, how they run it all. The people that run this government, let me explain something to you. You think they're wimps? When they're trying to teach kids how to wear rainbow flags, that's just to neutralize you and make you be obsessed with some right they don't care about one way or another. While you're dancing around with rainbow flags, like, my revolution worldwide, they are poisoning you. They are grabbing little kids, putting them on C-130s and flying them in to all different torture centers around the world where rich people will pay $500,000 to torture them to death. And I'm sorry to be this hardcore. It's just you better wake up, you better grow up, you better stop being idiots if you're a new listener. Because the truth is hardcore, and only the truth will set us free. I'm Alex Jones, Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.tv, Inside the Greek Coup, straight ahead with David Knight. In the last hour, I broke down the big threat to humanity. A scientific technological elite that has seized control of the brain trust of the West and our treasure, and our arms, and our knights, to launch evil wars across the planet against enemies they've helped create and foster, to destroy our name, to destroy our treasure, but to also establish a planetary government on the ashes of that. The TPP is secret. Three sections are public that were leaked. Draconian takeover of free speech, banking, private property, local hospitals, a total control of society. You expand from there. Greece has a historic no vote. And now their president was basically held overnight. Suddenly we hear in the morning that, oh, there is a deal, despite how the people voted, and the infrastructure is being handed over to Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan, and others that control the EU. The EU is designed to take over nations and bankrupt them. It was Goldman Sachs and others that helped get Greece into the euro and lied about the debts to, again, position them. This is economic conquest in their own words. This has come out in the Economic Forum minutes. It's come out in the World Bank and IMF documents. This is a predatory fact. Yes, it's true that the country had socialist politicians put into power to maneuver them towards being dependent. But the lion's share of the debt is derivatives they've been signed on to. So the point is they will never emerge from economic bondage if they're unable to self-determine. So now their vote of the people in the birthplace of people power, Greece, has been overrun and overruled, and it's not even really in the news. Or it's a footnote in the Wall Street Journal or a footnote in AP. Oh, overnight a deal was struck for the entire infrastructure, the national parks, the islands, the airports, the roads. It'll all now be in secret meetings given away at pennies on the dollar as a direct tax by the banks. Oh, and capital controls for 6 months. Oh, and direct taxes out of your paycheck to private banks. This is direct payment to the mega banks. What did they call for 3 years ago at Davos? London Independent headline. Soros and others want $100 trillion a year liquidity. Davos is the headline, wants $100 trillion every decade to be paid to them. This is true corporate, private, global governance and is the model that will then take down Spain, Portugal, Ireland, Italy, then France, then the UK. And this is the direct plan. We broke this down in my film Endgame 8 years ago. Just to document that this is not us speculating on current events. We predicted it all. David Knight has got a stack of breaking news on this front. David, I got to tell you, the most amazing facet of all this for me is that it's not in the headlines. Stealth coup in Greece. We need to get our writers on this right now to get an article out because no one else, it seems, there are a few Greek newspapers saying it. This is unprecedented. And the people are saying, why did we even vote a week ago, Sunday? Well, a week later, boom, what happened? Chronicle it right now, David Knight.
Well, there is a hashtag, Alex, out there, hashtag this is a coup. And the former finance minister, Varoufakis, has said that he compared it to the 1967 coup d'etat that installed the military dictatorship in Greece. He says, in the coup d'etat, the choice of weapon used in order to bring down democracy then was tanks. This time, it is the banks. The Financial Times has dubbed it the most intrusive economic supervision program ever mounted in the EU. This is a situation, Alex, where they're going to be raising pensions. They're going to be cutting. They're going to be cutting pensions. They're going to be raising taxes. They're going to raise the retirement age. They're even telling them, Alex, that they've got to work longer hours. They're going to. The EU is saying you're going to have to get rid of those laws that say that stores can't be open on Sundays. This harkens back to what Jeb Bush just said this last week. The media softened it. They said, well, he said people need to work longer hours. He just meant that they need to have the opportunity to work longer hours. That's not where these people are coming from. And the real concern is that over the will of the people, I mean, a week ago, we were all excited. We saw the Greek people say.
Oh, we knew they were going to strike back and Curtin M.O. wrote, they're going to launch a coup.
Yeah, yeah. We saw the Greek people say, Moulin Labe, come and take it in defiance. This week, we see after they browbeat the prime minister of Greece, he says, come and take it in a supine position. They said two different reports said he looked like a beaten dog after he came out of these meetings.
Absolutely. Whenever Nigel Farage, the leader of UKIP in the EU Parliament, said, you know, you've done the right thing, but now they're going to come after you. You need to devalue currency now. Folks will want to come there because it's cheap. You're going to be a slave forever if you don't do this. The EU is meant to destroy you. And then if we pull back and look at this, this is what the globalists have done in every other country. They're following a scenario here. Mm-hmm. And I want to put up the article that Curtin M.O. wrote, Washington preparing Greek coup. That was on Tuesday, 2 days after they had their referendum. We had the article with the intel that they were preparing the coup. And what's wild is they admittedly have been preparing with NGOs coups inside Russia, and the Russians are not going to go along with this. So this is just incredibly dangerous. There's the headline from July 6th. U.S. preparing coup to prevent Greece from falling under Russian influence. So this Tuesday.
You know, a week ago, Alex, they were saying the Greek people rejected an $8.5 billion extend and pretend loan. This week now, it is $86 billion total package that they're coming in. They are hammering these people to teach them a lesson. They had the audacity to say no to these people.
Well, we had the intel that they wanted them to actually vote no and that they were really getting them ready to set them up.
Yeah, yeah. They're going to take $50 billion worth of hard assets. I think it's not only a financial move, but it's also, I think, symbolic. They're going to take their power generation stations. They're going to put it into a fund.
They're totally conquering them.
Yeah.
They're totally conquering them. And notice, just like all these other countries they've done it to, they'll never get out of it.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
And then it'll make the culture go completely criminal, not paying taxes, drugs, prostitution, which the globalists will then launder and control as well. And they'll go the way of Mexico, the way of everybody else.
That's the way that it's always been. Going back to the World Bank, the IMF Fund, They were talking about how you're making loans to countries that's not about improving their infrastructure or their productivity. You're making loans to them to increase a welfare state because you're seeking rent. You want to turn them into renters.
Well, the IMF and World Bank are on record. They only give the money to their private global subsidiaries. They don't give the loans to the countries.
That's right.
They give the loans to their companies. And they go, we'll give a $2 billion loan to a national district for your water. If you give it to us, the water district, say, in one country I was reading was worth like $20 billion. They get it for a couple billion dollars, and then they still keep them in debt after the purchase for the maintenance of it and then double and triple water prices.
Yes.
I mean, this is the opposite of privatization.
Well, Varoufakis had addressed, back in the middle of June, he had addressed a meeting, and he said, if you really want to pay off the private investors in Greece and Greek people who have loaned this money to the Greek people. He said he opposed this because he knew that they couldn't pay it. He knew that they were going into debt that they were not going to be able to get out of. He goes, but they've enacted these austerity programs, which make us even less able to pay the debt.
That's in the IMF World Bank plans leaked in 2002.
Exactly.
Is they raised the taxes so it's impossible. They already have huge taxes on tourism. They wanted to add another 15% VAT across the board, which will make it too expensive to go there.
Yeah,
I mean, they know exactly what they're doing. It'd be like telling a hamburger place, you got to charge $50 for a hamburger when your competitors' burgers are just as good for $7.
And they always love to pull this in when they've got a socialist government or when they got a Democrat in charge of the U.S. and the president. They bring in the North American Free Trade Agreement, or they bring in the TPP, the TTIP, the Transatlantic Trans-Pacific Agreements, because they know that they're going to get a large part of that political party thinking, we're going to be protected because we've got a guy who's standing there for the people. Look at what Hugo Chavez did in Venezuela. The bankers were bragging about how they got 700% return from Venezuela because Hugo Chavez realized that their debt was most important, that they would get their money before he would get food, water, and medicine for his people. And that's precisely what has happened there. We're seeing the same kind of sellout from the socialists in Greece as well.
They always sell you out the worst from their jumbo jets and their red carpets. Now, remember, we saw thousands of trillions of fake fiat counterfeit that every country signed on to in 2008, another global governance move, as they threatened worldwide financial meltdown if we didn't. They dropped the stock market 35%. Everybody panics. We'll do whatever you want. Yep. They're given hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of billions of dollars per megabank. They're given trillions in open window Federal Reserve money, 0% interest. Mm-hmm. And then they sit around lecturing everyone saying, you've got to work more hours.
Yes.
It is simply insane, knowing that America has the hardest working people in the world. If you work, they've got international studies. The working class in America, that means middle class as well, works on average 67 hours a week. The other average in Europe, something like 41. Now imagine, 41 hours isn't lazy. 67 isn't lazy. So they know those of us that are prideful, those of us that like to work, those of us that wouldn't be caught dead in a welfare line, they know those of us that don't want to figure out subsidies and play the games and take the politicians out, you know, out to dinner and give money to the mayor so they make me tax exempt locally. I mean, I've been told by tax lawyers that's what you do.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you give political money, you go out to dinners, you do all this, and then you get to, I mean, it's insane. They know we won't do that, so they can just keep raising taxes, and we told everybody, they want digital money. They want to get rid of cash so they can shut down grassroots economies and so they can take over every single economy in the world and then just take the money out of your account. 6 months of capital controls. They're saying they're going to grab 30% out of everybody's bank accounts in Greece on top of their whole infrastructure. And you watch, we'll be here in 5 years talking about another bailout. In Germany, I'm going to hope to do one more segment, cover the other headlines. In Germany, 3 years ago, they announced nationwide to women that have been out of work for more than a year and that are attractive, you go in to see the bureaucrat, and the bureaucrat tells you, we've got a liaison in the legal brothel district. You're going to start having sex with 10 men a day. And they say, okay, because you've got to now pay back the welfare you've been paid. So even if you go to work, you got to pay us, and the government is now the pimp. So Rome, before it collapsed, they made the gentry, the patrician class, whore their wives out in public sex parties. This is where it's all going. Alex Jones here, back live. David Knight riding shotgun. I'm giving the numbers out at the end of this segment. We'll be opening the phones up. But globalism is a trap. The New World Order is a takeover. everything they push is premeditatedly evil under a Machiavellian plan that the end justifies the means. We must break with the New World Order and everything it promotes. We must get back to human communities, true local sustainability, and an honor, a chivalry, or we're going to lose everything. I want to get back to what's happening in Greece, the model for the world. But first, here's Admiral Akbar on the Greece situation.
It's a trap.
Just thought we'd add that. Let's play it one more time for the kids out there watching.
It's a trap.
Maybe one more time. Because all of this is not a very good thing. And, you know, I'm trying to throw some levity in here. This is very, very sad. We got 5 minutes left in this segment, David. You got a bunch of articles. You've got the floor. I'm just very upset about this. Run over what's actually happening over there and the president disappearing overnight, the rest of it.
Well, you know, Alex, they had a 16 hours of negotiation. After 14 hours, the Greek prime minister and Angela Merkel, because this is really kind of a conflict between them primarily. It was the Germans that were really pushing this, especially Merkel.
Doesn't Germany owe Greece a bunch of money for invading them? They never had to pay reparations at the end of World War II for that.
That's right. The Nazis confiscated a massive amount of gold that they never repaid. And then afterwards, in 1953, Greece was a part of a large number of countries that forgave German debt after World War II. So, yeah, there's a couple of different issues like that. But they're not very forgiving about this because they are using this as a coup. That's what everybody is talking about. After 14 hours of negotiation, Alex, they got up to leave, and the president of the European Council, Donald Tusk, said, sorry, but there's no way you're going to leave this room because they're not going to let this happen. You know, it was back in 1826 that somebody tweeted out on this hashtag, this is a coup. They said, this is a quote from John Adams in 1826. He said, there's two ways to conquer and enslave a nation. One is by the sword. The other is by debt. And that's precisely what we're doing. But this has an added dimension to it in the sense that we're going to see this just like the German invasion of Poland. People needed to understand that was a setting up a precedent of how the Germans were going to conduct themselves. This is how the globalist bankers who created the EU with the Bilderberg Group, I mean, there's a bunch of former Nazis who did that to start with. This is their plan for global domination, beginning in Europe and then moving elsewhere. It's this banker plan. Even though Greece is only about a 13th the size of the money that was lost in this Chinese stock market thing, it still establishes a lot of precedents, and we can see how
they're doing exactly what we said all these preparations were for.
Yes,
all the announcements, we got to get rid of cash, we got to get rid of barter, we got to shut down local sales, we got to stop, you know, the farmers markets, because they're getting ready for a depression. They want to social engineer us during the depression. It could backfire and ignite local commerce again. If that happens, that will screw up their technological technocracy.
Mm-hmm.
And the rise of the robots. They've got to get humans down on their knees. They've got to get us dependent.
The two things that I thought were so astounding about this particular agreement too, Alex, was that, of course, they're taking 50-some-odd billion euros in terms of privatization companies, and they're going to put that into an investment fund. They say, well, it was a victory for the Greek prime minister that that fund is going to be based in Athens and not Luxembourg. But look, this is a crony capitalist fund. It is nothing but crony capitalism. As Max Kaiser pointed out, only the really big banks can even get an access to that. Everybody else will be sold shares.
The top three or four Greek oligarchs will be given entree into the slush fund, but no one else will.
That's right. And then, of course, the other part of it is, as the London Financial Times said, this is the most intrusive economic supervision program ever mounted in the EU. They're going to tell them how to raise taxes. They're going to cut their pensions. They're going to open up closed professions. They say they're going to change Sunday trading laws. Even milk producers and bakers will be under the regulation of Brussels.
And by the way, since I mentioned it earlier and it sounded so wild, they found a London Telegraph article, not the one I'd seen out of Der Spiegel a few years ago, but another one, even older, from 2005, London Telegraph, where a woman had lost her job as a waitress. And they said, okay, at the employment office, we're going to send you to work at a brothel. You're pretty hot. She said, no, I don't want to have sex with 10 men a day. That was what they wanted her to do. And so they kicked her off her welfare.
Yeah, yeah.
There's the headline. If you don't take a job as a prostitute, we can stop your benefits.
Yeah.
So I'm not joking. When I said in Rome, by the time it collapsed, they were making the Roman wives of the elite have sex at public brothels to raise money.
Absolutely. This is what this is leading to. And we can see this coming in by degrees as some of the people were writing, this is misery, humiliation, and slavery. We have to understand that serfs in medieval times paid 10, in some cases 15%. That's nothing. If we could get to that level.
I pay almost 70%.
Exactly.
Because I'm an actual business owner.
Exactly.
I mean, so it's a joke.
We're far worse off than the serfs and the slaves. And this is serfdom. This is slavery. This is a taking of sovereignty, not just humiliating them financially, but humiliating them in terms of.
It's unprecedented. And it's being prepared for everyone else.
That's right.
Who's hosting the news tonight, 7 o'clock?
I'll be.
All right. Day to night. Tonight, 7 o'clock Central, PrisonPlanet.tv. I'll get the number out, your calls, and more news straight ahead. Monday through Friday, from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central Standard Time, we are here live. Appreciate you joining us today. I'm your host, Alex Jones. Anthony Gucciardi is sitting right here next to me. I will do this. When he leaves, I'm going to open the phones up for the entire balance of the transmission on any subject we've raised, total wild card, old-time callers, new callers, first-time callers. If you disagree, tell me. We'll shoot you to the head of the line. And, guys, there'll be so many calls on the screen. Just tell me the first five or six and point out to me if somebody disagrees. So I have a tendency not to read what they're calling in about. I just go to them just from the first to the last. So we're going to take your calls, 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. And we will get you here on the transmission, the radio/TV transmission. Don't forget, we have a free audio, video, podcast feeds, all of it, both live and the archives, at Infowars.com/show. And in a war, what are you doing to fight the tyrants? I think this show is one of the most aggressive wake-up calls, most accurate wake-up calls out there. I would be signing off on your emails, your Facebook, your Twitter, your Pinterest, your Instagrams with Infowars.com/show to find forbidden information. Key intel about the state of the world. Coming up, Anthony was in here going, man, you got to hit these headlines. Look at this stuff on your desk. I know. Taxpayers spend $3.5 million to find out why lesbians are fat. And then you see the joke headlines about, you know, $5 million for shrimp on treadmills. Well, actually, it was shrimp on Prozac on treadmills. And you ask, what is all this about? Well, I've been inside the secret areas, restricted areas of the University of Texas Psychology Department. That's basically, I talked about this 12 years ago, and I was allowed in twice. And I had to wait till the guy left to go be at MIT before I could talk about it. It was part of the rule. He could even say where he went. He didn't think they could figure it out. But it was all about basically how to screw up human sexuality and just how to make us alone with no family when you're 65 so they can euthanize you. Because, see, they know no matter how much drugs, how much brainwashing, somebody kills your kid, somebody does something wrong to your family, you might fight back. And there's enough of us, even when they got the robot armies ready, that they still might get defeated. And again, this is the end of humanity. Humans aren't going to go to space anymore. Military isn't. Forget just putting women in combat. That's just to get rid of the military and break it down. This is all the preparation. They didn't do it until they wanted to sabotage it. It is simply incredible. ISIS to send members of feared all-female police to Europe disguised as tourists to attack holy sites and spark religious war against Christians. And they've been caught putting out new fake videos with the Pentagon. And again, not our average troops, but the criminal takeover artists that are in control. That's all coming up. The latest on Iran, the latest on Russia. Huge video on Infowars.com. U.S. conspiring with Russian oligarchs to overthrow Putin, says Duma member. And I love, Watson wrote a great article, but I love how there's this 25-minute interview with one of the top guys in the Duma. And people say, is this true? It's on record the State Department's trying to overthrow Russia. It's on record they overthrew Ukraine. It's on record they're trying to overthrow all these other countries that surround Russia. They don't even deny it. And then even in Russia, the reporter's going, oh, yeah, what's your proof? Because it's a young trendy. And the guy keeps explaining, do you understand this is 21st century war? I can't pick up the phone and call the media. Most of it's Western run. And let people know it's a war because we're designed to face tanks and soldiers, an exact quote of mine. This is a 21st century new war, covert. It's a roundtable British Empire model where they buy off your top 1,000 people, promise them seats in power when they take over, or if they fail on the coup day, they've got planes waiting to get them out. And you watch this video, it's everything. And that's what's crazy. The Russians aren't perfect, but at a primitive level, it's still male-driven, basically almost prehistoric, but super smart, super high IQs. Yeah, they're drunk. Yeah, they fight a lot. Yeah, I mean, whatever. The point is that Russians only wake up when they're under attack. And so that's historically known. And so they now have state-run TV going, the plan is to destroy our family. Here are the documents. The plan is to, you know, put stuff in the vaccines. They get it. Because they already went through it under communism and their population went down by more than 30%. They've already been in the jaws of this forever. They've still got corrupt KGB people. They've still got socialism. They've still got problems. They've still got vestiges of it. But they really get what's going on. And when you get in the darkest levels of tyranny, light is that much brighter. And secretly, most of the former KGB people at the highest levels, Vladimir Putin and others, made pilgrimages to Alexander Solzhenitsyn and would basically, in closed-door meetings, break down and cry and apologize for their betrayal of Russia and finding out that oligarchs had financed the bring-down of Russia in 1917, British and U.S. banks, the Bolsheviks, 40,000 folks from New York City and New Jersey were brought in alone, and the Russians now get it. That's why they declassified 10 years ago the KGB files that McCarthy was right. So the truth is the globalists want to bring down Russia because who would have ever thought, and they're scared to death. I'm not lionizing them. They're corrupt. They've got problems. But they don't want to kill themselves. They don't want to have robots take over. They don't want to give up their humanity. So they got state-run media going. They do not want us to have children. They want you to be gay, so you will not have children. Here's the document. We are not against gay people, but this is a plan. I mean, they're really, they will ban mother and father. That's now happening here. The nanny state is to make you totally subservient to phase you out. No dodgeball, no tag, no running, no shaking hands, no nothing. And so basically, even the Telegraph admits Russia collapsed. Much of that was real. But their KGB operatives in training, like a wind-up toy or an Echo, sleeper cells are still operating. And let me prove this. Do you know who created the neocon movement that basically runs the Obama administration today and the Republican leadership? On record, look it up. Trotsky, Leon Trotsky, the number two guy in the Soviet Union under Lenin. Stalin didn't like him. Trotsky fled with hundreds of his operatives to Mexico, where he was killed with an ice axe. Used to chop up blocks of ice, paid by Stalin. When they failed, they all came to the U.S., got Rockefeller, Carnegie, and Ford funding because they just funded them 30 years before to go take over. They weren't running to the U.S. because it was that's where they came from. They originally came from Russia and Poland, were sent back over to take over. Stalin kicks them out. They come over here, and now they are the Republican Party. Hardcore Trotskyites. Hardcore. They give you the Patriot Act, everything else. I mean, we're in deep trouble. We are in deep, 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 deep trouble. And I only wish Stalin would have got all of them. I got to be quite honest. Trotsky, these people, that's some bold statement there, but I got to tell you, Stalin was horrible as hell as well. I wish he did. I mean, Hitler, all of them. I don't want economies based on this. The point is that we're in deep trouble. The neocons went and took over Harvard, and they went over and took over the Chicago Business School. This is all admitted. Ron Paul gave a 45-minute speech called Neocon back in like 2006, 2007. Go watch it, where he talks about all this. So you wonder why we're under this now. The Trotskyites have always wanted to destroy Russia. Take the member of Polish royalty, known as the Duke of the Milk Nobility. That's his title. Zbigniew Brzezinski absolutely hates the Russians, and his family had ties to the German-backed side of Poland in World War II. Same story yet again. Zbigniew Brzezinski wants to destroy Russia. And look, here's the deal, folks. The globalists hate America, too. They're shutting us down. We should be working with Russia in space exploration. We should be working with everybody. But no, the globalists want to bring down any sovereign, independent nation. And yes, the czars were corrupt. Yes, they were decadent. They were in their own world. They were more removed than anything. Their minions were corrupt, and they were taken out and executed by their cousins, the British royalty. In fact, the Tsar was almost an identical twin to the King of England. Look it up. Look up the Tsar next to his brother, the King of England. You could not tell the difference between them. They were so bred from the exact same German and Transylvanian bloodlines. No Russian in him. They were German royalty that had taken over all of Europe. There hasn't been British royalty in England, folks, since the Tudors. And so, by the way, I'm distantly related to all that. So you could say I'm as English as it gets. This is disgusting. Look at those two. You couldn't even tell the two apart. This is what breeding is, and they took them out. King of England is there with the bigger hat, and there's the Russian Tsar right beside him. All right, enough of that. I'm ranting. I'm going to stop right now. I'm very angry. I'm very upset. I've not plugged anything for an hour and 44 minutes, and I've got to fund this operation. We have the best quality products at InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com. We have free shipping in the month of July. It is your direct funding getting high-quality products, whether it's high-quality storable foods or high-quality cookstoves or high-quality firearms accessories or high-quality books, videos, 25% off Molon Labe products, 10% off all the T-shirts, InfoWarsStore.com. But I've got Anthony Gucciardi in here. Because we've got good news. Prostagard has been sold out for, what, 2 months? It is the strongest, lowest priced, hands down. We went through the industry to the three of the biggest manufacturers. We said we want something that has the most ingredients, the most concentrated, the cleanest, triple tested, totally organic, at roughly half the price of the leading competitor. Men knew how important this was. Quite frankly, women should be taking this because it just affects a whole bunch of glands. This is one of the few products we have where even the U.S. government and the FDA admits this is proven to help the prostate. Prostagard is back at InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsLife.com, or call 888-253-3139. We are days away from selling out of X2. It appears that we may have procured more of the crystals. They're in transit right now. The purest form of iodine, if you want X2, InfoWarsLife.com. It still looks like it'll be 3 weeks till we get more brain force in. But of the 14 products, we've got 8 of them in now. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. Anthony Gucciardi, I want to get your take on my whole rant right there about the state of the world, Greece, Russia, all of it. But before we do that, tell folks what we can say on record from Science Daily, the rest of them, from the Mayo Clinic about the ingredients that are in Prostagard. Tell folks what's in it.
You know, the core message of natural health and of InfoWars Life has always been to be not just life-changing, but to fight back against the numerous methods of attack that we sustain on a daily basis against our bodies. And one of those key things is a hormonal attack that we've talked about, but specifically, I don't think people understand what BPA really is. And every single thing that we do, we are exposing ourselves to these toxic chemicals that we're finding time and time again are damaging things like our prostate. So that's why we developed Prostagard as a way to fight back. Just like all the other products have a purpose to fight back numerous attacks, the prostate is being attacked on a daily basis and most people don't even realize it. So I wanted to highlight this one article here from Science Daily. It says BPA linked to prostate cancer study shows. And it goes on to say that not only is exposure to BPA just causing prostate cancer, it can actually be used, basically, levels of BPA in men's urine could be a marker of prostate cancer. So low levels could actually, statistically, if you have low levels of BPA, it's more likely that you're not going to develop prostate cancer. If you have high levels, it's more likely that you
are. Bottom line, most of the microwavable liners have it. Most of the bags you cook in the microwave have it. You are literally getting mega dosages of an estrogen mimicker.
It's beyond that, too.
And again, they had thousands of plastic formulas. We're going to skip the network break. It's so important. They had thousands of plastic formulas. We've talked to the top chemist. They chose this to put it in the food chain. It's in the printer ink. It's in everything to feminize men and to make women ultra feminine. That's why they gain so much weight and then become the hyper female. I can answer the Fed's question. Taxpayers spend $3.5 million to find out why lesbians are so fat. Conversely, gay men end up being very, very skinny. And it all ties into hormone imbalances in most cases. That doesn't mean that some people don't naturally have a proclivity towards same sex. I'm not judging anybody. This is science we're talking about. Go ahead.
That's right. And I mean, we have the direct connection. Dr. Group's father was one of the individuals who worked to get BPA into the system without knowing what he did. And that's why Dr. Group's life mission has been to help people, because unfortunately, his lineage has been developing things for Exxon and different plastics, BPA contaminants.
His dad is one of the inventors on record. You can look up the patent for Exxon before it was Mobil. For BPA.
That made billions of dollars, and he was paid like nothing for it. So anyway.
And he was going to go public right before he died.
Yep. That's exactly right. It's a really, really sad story.
Got one of those two-week cancers.
Yes.
Then the FBI showed up,
mm-hmm.
just like Tesla.
And then he died. So this is the real deal stuff. This is real deal. And the FDA looked into banning at BPA because we made such a big deal about it, because activism does work.
Yeah, they have banned it in Europe.
Yep, and they banned it in Canada for most baby formulas. But in the FDA looked at it here in the United States, but they were lobbied so hard by this multi-billion dollar industry that makes money off of BPA. They said, you know what? It's perfectly safe. But that also goes into this. How many of the listeners right now drink soda? A daily serving of soda, daily serving, okay, daily serving, increases aggressive prostate cancer risk by 40%. All right. And that's not just because there's
mainstream studies. We wonder why we're all dying of cancer. They admit the fertilizer they put on corn that they make corn syrup out of. What was the Washington Post headline? The headline, I think, was 90% of corn syrup has high levels of lead and mercury. That was the headline.
Yep. That's pretty much what it is. It's Washington. Yeah. Washington Post. High fructose corn syrup contains mercury. Pretty much all of it.
That's one of the headlines. Yeah.
So this obviously ties into that, but also this is from the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition. And the reason
why are you being racist against BPA?
I am being racist, and this is just one serving per day. Imagine how many people are drinking more than that.
Let's just talk about the rebel flag, though, not something giving us cancer on record, dying horribly with tubes all in us, with our children being chopped up, pediatric cancers up 10,000%, Gardasil murdering people. Let's just talk about the rebel flag today.
Yeah, that's a good distraction. Or we could talk about, you know, the $3.5 million spent to find out why lesbians are fat. None of this, you know, just like you were talking earlier about the different groups of individuals running things and the different...
They're three times fatter on average.
Right.
Well, because it is genetic. They've been triggered genetically. Genetics loads the gun. Environment pulls the trigger. I mean, the Pentagon admits they have a pheromone spray that will make men violently attracted to other men. It's called the gay bomb. BBC, folks, we're not joking about this. British Broadcasting Company.
Yes. And also, you think about it, at the most base level, anything scientific these days, you're not allowed to talk about in the public. Like, we're not allowed to talk about the BPA that actually makes animals turn gay. But that's a whole different story, right? Because that's silly. That's so stupid. That's not real. But it goes into this, too. The deadly pesticides that are in our food and water, like Monsanto's herbicide, which the World Health Organization recently admitted is causing cancer, that's also giving you prostate cancer. And how much Roundup are we eating on a daily basis? I mean, it's in our water supply. It's in every single food we eat, pretty much, that it's loaded inside the GMOs.
And top scientists, now that I was told this by a top banker, I went and researched it, say, we will adapt to it, so we automatically go, I don't care if this cigarette's going to kill me and has additives, I'm going to smoke it. Or, oh, whatever, I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing. We're designed in our development to go through hell, so we kind of like being attacked. No, we don't have to wait till we get the diagnosis and get the cancer. We need to take the stuff out of our lives that's doing this. We need to filter our water. We need to tell folks what's in the prostate guard, because it's not just the saw palmetto that they admit does this. Tell them what else is in here and why this product's such a bestseller.
Right, and we can talk about the saw palmetto a little bit because it's so powerful. And it's one of those things where, you know, you're going to develop a prostate formula and you say, well, you got to put saw palmetto in it. But we didn't know at the time when we were developing this that lycopene is the new saw palmetto. It's really this pigment that is found in the liver, in your blood, in the prostate, obviously. And we don't entirely know how it works as a function of the human body. But the studies are pretty clear. And we can't totally get into them on air, but lycopene is extremely, extremely powerful. I can read you some documentation about it from the Mayo Clinic. But it is the new saw palmetto. And then the plant sterols in there as well are pretty much the real deal. Alex is... If you're not watching, he's... basically chugging Prostagard as I talk about the benefits. That's what it makes me want to do, too. Sometimes when I talk about these products on air, even though, you know, I'm taking them pretty much on a daily basis.
Even though you're a racist.
Even though I'm a racist. I'll talk about them so much that I will go back immediately after this and take a lot of them.
Look, it feels so good because between me and God and everybody else watching, I don't do something that I wouldn't want done to myself. That's why I've got such good luck. knock on wood. I just praise God for everything, the success, the protection we've been given, the discernment. Every time we have an enemy, all their intel falls on our lap without asking. I've experienced the providence that George Washington experienced. I'm just humbled. And so we only go out and bring you products. That's why the super hippies and the super health conscious people, you go to third party sites and just read reviews of our stuff. They go, wow, this is really affordable, very competitively priced, a very strong formula. I can't believe that it's Alex Jones putting this out. He's a right-wing nut. I mean, even there, people that don't like me who are total snobs about their supplements are admitting that we put out absolute gold.
You know, I think I'm one of those snobs about the supplements, too. So I like the designation of super hippie as well. There are a lot of people super surprised. I mean, they talk to me on a daily basis. They're like, so Alex Jones is putting out this Prostate Guard or the Superman Vitality? This is amazing. I can't believe this. You know, there's a large group of people that go to InfoWars Life and just cannot actually understand what's going on because they're saying, well, wait a minute. These are the highest quality products. These are higher quality products than some natural health websites out there.
It's because they're cheap. We could make this bottle for $1, including the bottle, or we could put $10 in it and still make a profit and fund things. I mean, why not have the Ferrari of supplements for a Ford LTD price? I mean, it's just called free market domination.
360 win.
Absolutely. InfoWarsLife.com. I want to thank you all for your support. The new Prostate Guard is back in. We only got a limited amount because we have to budget things. Who knows? Sometimes something sells out the first time, it doesn't the next. But we now where are we? I know I've scrounged up the money to reorder everything. So when is everything coming in?
We're working on it. There's a lot of stuff that gets sold out because obviously we don't have massive funds to just dump into tons of products. So we have to see how they sell. You know, we have to have waiting lists. That's why BrainForce, you can sign up for the waiting list. You can sign up for the waiting list on LiverShield. All of these products that sold out, we need to gauge the, you know, attention to it and the desire.
LiverShield sold out in 4 days.
It did.
BrainForce in 4 or 5 days.
3 days.
Okay. Boy, I miscalculated on that one. And then
it comes down to high quality products, though. You know, we like you said, we could spend $2. We could get tons of more BrainForce in the next day. But instead, it takes 2 to 3 months for every single batch to be done. And we desire that it's super high quality and would demand it. So we're not going to go ahead and say, okay, it's sold out. Let's get the $2 crap from China. We're still going to stay with the high quality product.
And again, we only use grass certified, FDA approved. And by that, by FDA approved, like these are things certified as known as safe supplements.
Right. Generally recognized as safe, processed by either NSF or GMP, good manufacturing process.
They test it 2 times, each ingredient. That's what's so expensive. We test it again, neurotically, knowing we have enemies that may get our products and spike it for a test. So we have them in a sealed safe, all certified, outside lawyers coming in. I mean, you know, we have enemies. So we thank our enemies, helping us even make it better. And we know our enemies are so upset, they haven't been able to, by the grace of God, find anything. In fact, the labs keep freaking out, saying you're even passing California standards on all your products at higher levels. That's why so many products only have one ingredient, because you can get one that's clean, but not 10 that are clean. But labs are calling us saying, we've never seen this before. So this is how neurotic we are.
There's a reason that when you go online, personally, I shop for supplements all the time. There's a reason why it'll say does not ship to California. It's because sometimes we still have to put warnings in because the laws are so ridiculous. But if you cannot ship to California, oftentimes it's because you don't want to deal with Prop 65 or I believe it's 65, where the limits are so low. But oftentimes it's because, like you said, they have to just pick one ingredient or else they can't hit the levels. They are so many massive amounts of heavy.
And let's be clear, the lead levels are so high, they don't care if it's raining in from China in the jet stream or whatever. There's more lead in the air than the California standard.
Right.
There's more arsenic in an apple than the standard.
And is the difference.
But then they'll dump hundreds of chemicals under the name fluoride in your water at thousands of times what they admit is safe, while they won't let you sell products that have any toxins in them. That's so lawyers can get a product, test it, and then sue you.
Right. And there's radium in the water supply and antibiotics and birth control, but that's fine. Don't care about that. As long as your supplements can't contain any organic-based metals, right? Because there are synthetic and organic metals. If you're in the dirt and you're eating dirt, you're going to have some quote-unquote contaminants, and some of them are actually good for you.
Well, that's what my dad even says as a chemist. He goes, well, son, it's almost like this hidden good. It's so clean. We need some traces of all that. I go, whatever. This is the cleanest stuff that we can find at the highest quality, InfoWarsLife.com. Third hour coming up. I'm going directly to Jason, John, Tom, Walt, Bill, InfoWars.com. All right. This hour will be a day long remembered. I will take 30 phone calls, or CJ will be allowed to hit me in the head with a baseball bat. I'm joking. But I'm going to take a lot of your calls, and I'm going to move to the next person. I'm going to go to Jason, then John, then Tom, then Walt, then Bill, and others. When you hear me hang up on somebody, that is your chance to call in. I would love to hear from you. 800-259-9231. I'll just mention the other news coming up in the next segment. I want to go ahead and go to your calls now. Jason in North Carolina, thanks for holding. You're on the air.
Thank you, Alex. And I want to thank you for helping me to achieve discernment. I've been listening since around 08. I'm going to make 3 points in rapid-fire succession, and I'll go off air and listen to what you have to say about them. First of all, in the vein of the Confederate flag thing that has been addressed a lot, but I just want like to say I don't think slavery, as you always say, it's not 300, 400 years ago. It's actively happening because people are buying electronic devices that are made in essentially slave dungeons in many cases, you know, i.e. Apple Corporation. So,
And listen, I'm a hypocrite. There's almost, it's hard to find goods that aren't made basically in slave-like environments. Germany makes out-of-work women go work at brothels. That's slavery.
Sir, and you look at the corporate prison complex that employs prisoners at slave wages. They have contracts with these multinational corporations. And a lot of this, if you try to find out information on it, it's very hard to get information because a lot of that information is sealed about what exactly they're doing. But they're like good wages for those corporations, around $2 to $3 an hour in prison, and the lower end is about 50 cents an hour.
And all these good old boys my whole life go, they got hot tubs and cigarettes in prison. I want the AC turned off. I want them working. Nobody's got that in prison but white collar criminals that have like cable and stuff. They are working for 25 cents to a dollar an hour, displacing everybody else's jobs. And then they go, what, are you against prisoners? Are you racist against prisoners? No, we shouldn't be competing against prisons. A great example is the fiction movie, but it's based on true stuff that happened, The Shawshank Redemption, where he's got the prisoners out building the highways for cheaper than the private companies can. Go ahead.
Undercuts competitions. Point number two, sir. In the last 50, 60 years, you have institutions like the University of Kentucky refusing to even allow African-Americans on their sports team. Okay, and today,
excuse me,
same minorities. What was that? Well, University of Kentucky. I mean, do you remember when Pat Riley was a player there, and they played that all-black team, and essentially only white people were allowed onto the basketball team, and Jackie Robinson wasn't allowed to play for the LA.
Oh, I thought Dodgers. You were talking about currently. Yeah, sure. Okay, yeah,
no,
go ahead.
No, I'm talking about in the lifetime of people. You know, in the lifetime of your parents and my parents, because we're about the same age, but. Do people look back, and now that wasn't 300 years ago, that was in our lifetime, but people continue to wear these logos, and you know what, that if you're going to have that attitude about the Confederate flag or anything for that matter, then why not say, hey, you were a virulently a racist organization 50 years ago, I'm not going to wear your logo anymore because of that. Now, do I think that's necessary? No, I don't, but do I think it's a double standard?
Sure.
Yes, I do. It's just like buying an Apple phone. But there's a third point I'll make, sir, because I heard you brought this up on the show a couple of days ago. I had a good friend who sat next to a Mexican high government official. And just like you said the other day, this guy, he said he looked like a white guy. And he said that he was talking about the native Mexicans, a lot of them who migrate here. He said he had nothing but disdain and hatred.
Yeah, the most racist people that I've ever read about or seen is ultra-rich Mexicans. A bunch of them live in Austin now, and a lot of them are really nice people, except it's like being in East Texas or something, and you run into some racist guys, and they start, it's really uncomfortable, and they'll just say the most horrible things about Mesoamericans that have native blood. And that's because, I mean, the Spanish went down there and just started murdering everybody, and it's still the Spanish that run Mexico. One of the stories up on Infowars.com, we're going to get to at the bottom of the hour. Twitter campaign encourages people to rip down Confederate flags. And it's got people running into front yards, backyards, side yards, cars, peeling stickers off. And again, regardless of what you think about it, this shows the power of the media. We're talking 10 to 15 black people being killed a week in Chicago, being shot by other blacks. You know, is there some flag we could pull down to blame that on? And this is just all part of, oh, you're an empowered group. You go and pull down a rebel flag, that will fix your problems. And what it's going to do is create division when we have so many serious problems to deal with. You've got people calling the police on folks that are selling rebel flags at swap meets and flea markets. And the police show up and go, well, you know, it's on private property, implying it's illegal. And I've told you, I said it before, Rush Limbaugh, before Farrakhan, next it'll be banned the American flag. And now the calls are happening. Even though American ideas helped end so much of what we call slavery across the world. But I want to go to your phone calls right now. I got two people that disagree, so they go to the front of the line. I'm going to go to Richard in Illinois, then Tom in London. Then we're going to go to John in Texas, Walt, Bill, and others. Richard in Illinois, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, I'm a big fan of yours. I want to disagree about Trump, and it's only because I don't think this guy takes orders from anybody. I'm not saying he's perfect, but you mentioned yesterday he was a ringer. I don't think he takes orders from anybody. My experience with him in Chicago is I've watched as he's built this god-awful building. He put this god-awful sign on it. He sued everybody to get this sign, and he just doesn't take no for an answer. So anyways, what I was hoping you would do is, if you think he's a ringer, why don't you invite him on the show and ask him?
We have invited Trump on the broadcast. And Nico, go after him again. Tweet at him. Everybody tweet at Trump and tell him come on the show. And I've said that's my opinion. And I've been told by Jerome Corsi, who's had a lot of conversations with Trump and others, that he suspects that that's what he's doing. And I respect Dr. Corsi. He's a really smart guy. Trump gives massive money to Hillary Clinton. I can't imagine that you're a real conservative and then you give to her senatorial campaign. And what he's doing is gobbling up all the attention and then not properly defending his ideas. The guy owns casinos. The guy is tied in with some really shady characters. After he did that whole birth certificate thing, he suddenly got his NBC contract renewed. So that's my feeling on Trump. My gut has never been wrong. Maybe he'll have a change of heart. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe a blue moon has arrived. Again, there's a headline. Donald Trump has spent years courting Hillary Clinton and other Dems. And so that's where I stand. I mean, he's like a cartoon character. People think he's the richest guy in America. He's worth $4 billion. He's a front man, in my view, for some other more powerful people. Bill and Melinda Gates are worth $78 billion on record. Warren Buffett, $73 billion on record this year in Forbes. Their real wealth is in the aggregate trillions. Donald Trump says a lot of great things and things I agree with. But he's shown by his actions that he's a pretty slimy guy. And look, I think people that own casinos are slimy. I've been around it. I've had a chance to be out to Vegas to see some fights and to be behind the scenes. And we know what's come out in the news about it. And I don't even feel good being close to it. I don't lecture people about gambling. You want to do it? Go ahead. You want to be a chump? Go ahead. If you and your buddies want to gamble over a poker game, that's completely different. That's just making the game fun. I get that. So I have gambled playing poker in my life, you know, not high stakes or anything. But the gamblers I know, instead of being competitive in life, instead of going out on a limb in life, they go out on a limb in just somebody else's rigged game. It's a fake paradigm to come into and be screwed. And I think chumps gamble for high stakes. It ruins a lot of lives. It's mentally ill. That's my opinion. And I think Trump is a predator for being involved in it. What do you say to that?
I somewhat agree with you. I mean, again, my only experience with Trump, I've never watched his show. I went to that Trump hotel in Chicago, and I had one drink. And I'm telling you, the employees over there were miserable. They did not smile. You could tell that they were exhausted. I find him exhausting. But he is moving the Overton window in a direction that, as a libertarian, as a Ron Paul, as a Rand Paul supporter, I kind of support. So it's kind of hard for me to say he's all bad when he is moving the Overton window. Now, am I being naive? I don't know. Are you wrong? Well, generally, you're not wrong. I agree with a lot of what you say. Matter of fact, best investment I ever made in my life was that Tangy Tangerine that I have every morning. But there's something there, and I don't see him. I see him creating his own reality. I tell you, not to produce your show, but the Dr. Pitch, I can't pronounce his last name.
Pachinik.
He might be able to give a really good psychological description of what Trump is. I mean, he might be a sociopath. I don't know. Pachinik would know. But I just see him moving the Overton window, and part of me says, that's a good thing.
No, I hear you, Richard. Let me move on to Tom in London. I can't really comment on your comments, or I won't have time to get to calls, but I can't comment too elaborately. Donald Trump is involved with a bunch of seedy people. Donald Trump is, people think, the richest man in America. You go out and ask folks, they think he is. He is a pop culture person who is involved in WWF. And it's not like Jesse Ventura was involved and now he's serious. Trump uses the same tactics in reality. And so, yes, to you who is awake, Trump sounds good. But the media is using what he said and misrepresenting it to then discredit everyone else. And so that's what's going on. I mean, I can take one look at Donald Trump and I hear this voice say, danger Will Robinson. I take one look at Rand Paul and go, that's the real deal, but they might kill him. And that's how it basically comes down, in my view. They have to have a straw man to destroy. So then they can say they've discredited an idea. I mean, it's outrageous, the criminal crime wave going on in Latin America that's pouring into the United States. I mean, Mexico is a failed state approaching hell, except in small jurisdictions that are controlled tourist areas like Cancun. It's very sad. It's a very beautiful country. Yep, former owner of Monday Night Raw, WWE Hall of Fame inductee. I mean, it's just clown behavior, folks. He works for the Democrats, in my view. He sure gives them more money than Republicans. Tom in London from Albion. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi, Alex. Good to be speaking to you again.
Welcome, my friend. Go ahead.
There are two issues that I just want to briefly disagree with you about today. The first one is the story about German women being forced into prostitution. Now, no German woman has ever been forced into prostitution in the way that you describe. Now, let me explain this. This story came about, it was 10 or 11 years ago, 2004. It was a story in a magazine called Taz. I think it's short for Taz Kolleger. And it was a speculative piece because there were two potentially opposing or a confluence of legal changes in Germany. The first one was legalization of brothels.
And then they were saying, can they be forced? And they found cases of it. But let's just move past that. Okay, you can argue whatever. Let's just say I'm wrong for the case of argument. Does prostitution massively increase as economies decline? And in the United States and England, are not record numbers of women going into prostitution driving down the price of prostitution?
Prostitution is on the increase, absolutely. And there are apps where young women.
Did Roman emperors make the gentry prostitute their wives to raise state funds?
Just for the sake of your listeners and for you, Alex, I just want to briefly finish the point about that story. Because what happened, that was a speculative piece. It was saying, what if someone was offered a job in a brothel, then this other law would come in and force them to take it. Now, the first thing is that this was a speculation not based on any particular case. The example was of a woman being offered an interview at a brothel for the role of a bartender. It's illegal since 2009 to advertise brothel positions in German job centres, and under their law, their constitutional law, when they legalised prostitution, it was absolutely illegal for anybody to be forced by coercion into prostitution.
Well, I know that's in the Geneva Convention as well. The point is economic degradation forces this, and this will be Greece's new cash crop. And I appreciate your call. We're out of time. We did put the London Telegraph and other articles up there where they're saying it's real people. This was going on. But I understand you're saying there's conflicting laws. The overall issue is, as economies go down, prostitution proliferates. And your new economies are casinos, prisons, prostitutes. And then there's no more families. Society unravels and we collapse into a hellhole. And so that's where I was going. I rest my case. Walt, Bill, John, Sean, stay with us. We'll be back. I want to rush through your calls now. We've been getting to some. They've been very interesting, very informative. But let's just go to folks and go to the next person. I'm going to hit some news coming up in the next segment, but then right back into the calls. Let's talk to Walt in Michigan. He wants to talk about the Vatican and the Pope. I don't think you can call him the Pope when he's calling for world government carbon taxes and excoriating capitalism. He should be criticizing crony capitalism, but I forgot he's part of that. But I guess I'm ranting instead of letting Walt talk. Walt, go ahead.
Well, Alex, I've talked to you for on and off for over 20 years, and I want to bring up a quote that David Knight mentioned, a quote from President John Adams. Well, John Adams made another quote. My history of the Jesuits is not eloquently written, but it is supported by unquestionable authorities and is very particular and very horrible. There, the Jesuit order's restoration in 1814 by Pope Pius VII is indeed a step towards darkness, cruelty, despotism, and death. I do not like the appearance of the Jesuits, if ever there was, a body of men who merited eternal damnation on earth and in hell. It is this Society of Ignatius de Loyola. John Adams, 1735 to 1826, second president of the United States, and this was his letter to Thomas Jefferson, who also died on the same day that John Adams did.
No, I know they did.
1826.
I know they did. That's what's amazing about it. Basically, they were big Enlightenment folks that were into human freedom. And that whole movement had been against some of the excesses of the church. And I'm not a Catholic. I have a lot of Catholics that have good fruits. You know, they're friends that are good people, great people. But I look at what the Catholic Church promotes. They've clearly been blackmailed. It's clearly been taken over by the Jesuits. It's in Catholic law. People can look it up that you're not supposed to have Jesuits as a pope. That's why you never had one till now. They're supposedly the secret police, basically, of the Catholic Church, the Society of Jesus, to keep it pure. Well, what's the greatest threat to a country or a religious country like Catholicism is a military takeover. And so basically the Jesuits, which was a military order founded by Loyola, as you mentioned, a general, went from Portugal, he was also in Spain, and now they've taken over. And they're saying, world government, pay your carbon taxes, redistribute wealth, but not the Vatican's. So that's why I am forced to absolutely criticize the Vatican because I've seen it as infighting. I just want to fight globalism, world government. But when unelected planetary government's being pushed on poor masses that are the main target of it by that snake in a papal gown, it really makes me just go ahead and not pull any punches. And again, I go with my gut and my spirit. Up until this point, it would be destructive to just sit there. But by the way, I can follow what the Pope's doing because he's big. All these Protestant groups are doing the exact same type of crap right now, and it's disgusting. And people need to shout it down. So send me your clips. It's like when Pastor Hagee, who gives some pretty good speeches, I've heard him give some great speeches on TV. I've watched him. He came out like 6-7 years ago and wrote a book, And I played the clip here going, Christ was not the Messiah, but a rebel against the Lord and the Jewish people. And he was dealt with. Read my new book where it describes that Christ was truly not the Messiah. And it's like, and then I also have family that in San Antonio that knows all about Mr. Hagee. I'm just going to leave it at that. And I won't get into stuff. Because later once I told my uncle about it, now rest his soul, it turned out that they lived, before he was huge, on the same street with him. And they would babysit his son. And the wife would come over, the wife he divorced. And he's just a big fat hypocrite. And here's the deal. I'm not up here judging anyone. It's just that, hey, he's a little false prophet. The Pope's a big one. There's no doubting it. Christ was not the Messiah, but a rebel in a war against the Jews and the coming Messiah. I mean, that's a quote, by the way. I played it so many times when it first came out. In fact, guys, look up Hagee says Christ is not the Messiah. I bet it's on YouTube. And so I just got to say, Pastor Hagee's a so-called Protestant, when really, I mean, with those type of statements, I mean, I would only expect that to come out of the mouth of the devil. So I'm sorry, he's not the false prophet. John Hagee is a devil, a portly little devil with a fake preaching voice. Welcome back to the broadcast. Alex Jones here, doing a Pastor Hagee imitation. The first thing you need to know is the most important thing for you to do is to order and secure your ProstaGuard today. The New World Order doesn't want you to have a healthy prostate, and things like saw palmetto and other key ingredients here are known to give you healthy prostate function. Available at InfoWarsLife.com. Just send your check or money order as well to InfoWars.com. All right, I'm going to stop right there. I need to actually watch some Hagee, and then I can do his accent dead on perfect. Now, before we go any further, I do want to return to your phone calls, but we need to just realize that the globalists are making their moves right now on every front. The globalists are showing us their hand. And if we just quietly submit to it and go along with it, Katie bar the door, there is no bottom to it. And so that's why I'm just upping my rhetoric to the level of what they're doing as it becomes more and more naked, as it becomes more and more obvious. I want to get into the latest on Al-Qaeda. I want to show video and photos and talk about it for the radio audience. Pluto at last, NASA spacecraft arrives for dwarf planet close-up tomorrow, but it's already getting some shots right now. We're going to go over all of this and more. But before we do that, let's go right to your phone calls. Bill in Wisconsin, thanks for holding. You're on the air.
Yeah, thanks, Alex, for taking my call. I listened to your report on Friday concerning Francis and coming out in favor of the New World Order. He also received the hammer and sickle crucifix from the communist head of Bolivia. But, and I've spoken to you about this before, this revolution in the church, the Catholic Church, and as a Catholic I can talk about it, did not begin with Francis. It began with Vatican Council II. It began with John the 23rd. He was
okay, well, I want you to speak to that, and I'll give you a few minutes to do it. But, I mean, all I know is this. Pope John Paul II supposedly got shot by the communists, helped bring down the Soviet Union, would never say things like this. So, I mean, Francis is just so bad. It's like having Fidel Castro as the Pope. I mean, am I wrong? Did you see him in South America be awarded a hammer and sickle award by a president?
Was anti-communist, and they would not let him out of the country, but they would let Karol Wojtyła, who became John Paul II, and he went to Harvard, okay, and received an honorary doctorate. He was a globalist in the true sense of the word. He was a complete sellout at the Vatican Council II. So it began with John the 23rd, Paul the 6th, who wore the ephod of Caiaphas, the high priest, instead of a cross on his chest. And it continued under Wotewa. This is something that has been going on for at least 100 years, but openly since Vatican Council II. I agree with you that, you know, we've got a Antichrist in the sense of Francis, okay? And he is definitely selling out the poor in Latin America. But, you know, it goes back earlier than this.
Well, I'm certainly aware that there have been a lot of power struggles, but even CNN reported that Pope Francis surprised by hammer and sickle crucifix. Oh, he's surprised by it while he was down in South America in Bolivia with the president giving him a hammer and sickle with Jesus nailed to the hammer. I mean, there's just no end to any of this. Let's talk about the Jesuits. What do you make of this being the first Jesuit pope?
You know, you keep bringing up canon law, and my wife and I have a used Catholic book business. We've got thousands of books, okay? We've got canon law books. I don't see it. So if you...
Okay, well, I've had some previous experts on, and I think I'm going to try to get them on, and I'm going from memory, but supposedly it was a big no-no, and they were barred from it because the Catholic Church, a couple of popes slapped down the Jesuits when they were trying to take over. Maybe that's been changed. But let me ask you this. Why has there never been a Jesuit pope?
Because their job within the church was to, you know, minister to Protestant populations, if you will, to try to bring them back into the church, missionary work throughout the world, you know, that type of thing. Go back to a book that both you and I got started on, None Dare Call It Conspiracy by Gary Allen. And in the front of the book, they quote Pedro Arrupe, who was head of the Jesuits at that time, saying essentially what you and I and others are saying. There is an elite, there is a cabal, there is, and maybe he was saying this because he was part of it, but I don't think so. Go back and look that up in None Dare Call It Conspiracy. You know, I think, you know, the Jesuits have done some harm, but they have also done some good from a Catholic viewpoint, and I know that won't be popular with a lot of your Protestant listeners.
Well, I mean, let's get past the Catholic-Protestant fighting, because that's only used as more balkanization. I know this. The Catholic Church and Catholics I've known have done a lot of good and stood up against a lot of tyranny, and a lot of most people I knew fighting the New World Order in the old days were older Catholic people. Undoubtedly, though, there's this giant leftist arm to it, liberation theology, that is super nasty. So I don't think we can debate that now the dominant mainline Catholic leadership is super bad news. Because what does it say that they elected this guy when, I mean, he talks like Lenin. I mean, it's so hardcore to see a pope spouting pure communist ideology and stirring up people. It's very dangerous. Very dangerous. And it just shows the globalists are making their move. So, Katie, bar the door, brother. I appreciate your call. I mean, we are in trouble. We are in big trouble. When he called for world government a month ago and started every day excoriating capitalism and saying wealth redistribution is the way to create living hell, and we've got some rich guy sitting on top trillions of dollars, and supposedly the wealth inside the Vatican is just over the top. Nothing like it on Earth. There's giant underground palaces, just vault after vault of diamonds, rubies, gold, artifacts, loot. It's just incredible history, the secrets of it. And the popes are bathing in huge gold bathtubs with sign of the zodiac carved in diamonds and emeralds and sapphires. I mean, you know what? I'd start buying into your communism if you went and sold it all and actually distributed it to all the poor people or something. But what you really need to distribute is anti-gambling, anti-tyranny garbage and push pro-family stuff. But we're not seeing any of that. Because you could give the poor people all the money in the world, they'd lose it in a week. Most of them. because they go play the lottery and they go into debt to buy more than they can get. You know, there's a reason poor people are poor. And previously, you could build a ladder for folks that had the proclivity to get out of it, to get out of it. But that's all being destroyed now. So don't worry. The Earth is sinking in to a very short dark age. Because the globalists want to set it up where you're totally dependent, totally dumb, under their control. And hey, you want your welfare? Get sterilized. Want your welfare? Take these shots. Then you wonder why you're dying 10 years later. And then the robot computer that runs the hospital says you don't get treatment. You don't even get told in the diagnostic you have cancer. You get told, go home and take these pills. But I always love big masses of poor people. The welfare crowd, whatever, not the working poor, who I respect. Sitting there demanding that they be given something for free. And Warren Buffett going, you're right, you deserve it. And the Pope going, you're right, you deserve some freebies. And Bill Gates and the Queen of England. Because they want to get rid of the middle class. They want to get rid of the Renaissance. They want to get rid of independent wealth. They want to get rid of choice. They want to get rid of different ideas they don't control. Because they know somebody that makes even $80,000 a year, $50,000 a year, $1 million a year, $5 million a year will be independent. And they're worried about them. That's why they have luncheons with elitists and luncheons with billionaires and luncheons with Congress people to get you there. And they say, we need you, Mr. Johnson. We need you, Mr. Sanchez. We need you, Mr. Chow. We need you, Mr. Schmidt. We need you, Mr. Drogoff or whatever, to be part of this and to help us. And they get good people that have made money and have businesses to join them and get directed by them, believing they're helping the community, when really they're just keeping tabs on you and watching you. And then by society's control and peer pressure, getting you to go along with it. And the big moves here, I mean, they're making their move. John in Texas, thanks for holding. You're on the air.
Hi, Alex.
Welcome.
One thing I want, if I could talk about Trump real quick. All Trump's going to do is pull the support away from Rand Paul. Right before the convention, he'll drop out. Jeb gets nominated. The conservatives stay home on election time, and Hillary gets elected.
That's it?
That's the game plan.
That's the game plan. But see, Trump's saying all these reasonable things. The out-of-control left misrepresents it. It makes conservatives and libertarians come defend him, and then Trump sits around with all his buddies laughing at us. And notice mainstream media saying his name thousands of times a day, 239 times a day on CNN. They just force-feed him to the public, and that's just how the cookie crumbles.
On a Confederate flag, what I'm afraid is going to happen is when the globalists so easy, the politicians caved in on bringing the Confederate flag down, they'll figure, hey, just stage one more last massacre, and we can bring down the Second Amendment. We can ram a gun bill right through there.
Well, yeah, they got smart. How do we stage something? And I think it was probably staged, looking at it all now, the way they pulled back, the way it was all done, orchestrated on the amnesiac drugs, able to get the gun when he shouldn't have got it in the list by the FBI. They were testing it. Well, if just guns can't do it, what if we tie it to an ideology and then make it about that? And absolutely, they're going to stage massacres just as sure as the sun came up, and blame it on the Second Amendment. I appreciate your call. God bless you. Sean in Colorado, you're on the air. Go ahead.
I wanted to talk about the financial collapse, and I think it's very clear in America. I really do. I think all these things are coming to a head, and I think the number one thing out of everything, I think the number one thing is the dollar being devaluated. And I think a financial collapse is almost certain. And I think that is one of the most important problems we should deal with in our country.
Well, I agree with you. And we're in a orchestrated collapse. They're making all the preparations, all the Ministry of Defense and Defense Department documents that we've shown and made films about admit it. They're building super creepy, giant, million-person emergency centers where they'll, quote, re-educate us. Hillary's giving speeches about men need to go to fun camps. Everybody's like, what a weird comment. I mean, we are being stalked by wolves. And the general public's had it good so long that when the hammer drops, they have no idea what's about to hit them.
The wolves are starting to circle. I mean, they're starting to, you know, it's time for us to circle the wagons and to bear down. Because
well, I agree. I mean, we should spend about a third of our time digging in, getting ready, and trying to be self-sufficient. But 70% affecting the future battle space of the info war that may get physical just out of defense necessity, to try to just emergency whatever stunt you got to pull that's legal and lawful. Pull the stunts to warn the people. Pull the stunts to tell folks about InfoWars.com. Pull the stunts. Get aggressive. Get AM and FM equipment if they shut down the media to be able to fire up with mobile centers to warn the public. I mean, they are coming. I mean, you just look at Hillary. She is a naked, power-mad, possessed goblin. I mean, heaven help us. People say, I've talked to top media people. They go, I bet you're looking forward to Hillary. Your ratings are going to skyrocket. And I'm like, no, I'm having to look at getting out of the country, because if they just shut off the media, there's no point in staying. I'm not a military person. It's not that I'm afraid of a fight, but I have a responsibility to take care of my children, and I'm going to fight as hard as I can in the info war and try to just go to the countryside when everything gets shut off and then defend myself if they come. But God, I just can't believe how real this is and how stupid people are, how caught in a trance they are. They have no idea how perilous it is. Anything else, Sean?
You actually look at it. It's amazing. This is all planned almost. And Hillary is just crazy.
She's completely mentally ill.
Yeah. The elite are crazy
to put her in. I mean, so many times in history, elites try to put their front person in, and then they take over. I mean, Hillary Clinton is so evil.
I wouldn't vote for her if she was the last lady on Earth. I mean, I wouldn't do it.
That's because you hate women. It's because you hate women. It's not that she's a tyrant and has a string of dead people behind her and takes money from dictators and is totally corrupt and, you know, has more girlfriends than Bill and all that. Oh, that's kind of cool, isn't it? But her followers kind of like the gangster stuff. They want the El Jefe. They want to bow to their queen of evil. I appreciate your call. Tom in New York, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Alex, good show as usual.
Thank you, brother.
What I'm about to say is that Trump is not only a man, but he's a $9 billion enterprise. So his contributions to Hillary make complete sense in that that's the price of doing business.
No, you're right. He wants to operate in her jurisdictions. You got to pay off the mafia. But, I mean, Donald Trump owns casinos. I just think that's very immoral.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you this. If we don't stop illegal immigration, it doesn't matter who's president. We are flooded for all the reasons we know. And for all the crimes we've just seen happen, I mean, it is the downfall of this nation.
Oh, listen. What Trump's saying is true, and Rand Paul says he will do something about it. I agree. Rand Paul should have been saying things like this. He said some things, but not hardcore enough. He should be out there in Trump's face saying, "Hey, we have a sensible way to do this." And you're up here grandstanding, so he would be the number one guy like he was 3 months ago. And I agree with you that Republicans need to get more aggressive.
Yeah, I mean, if we don't, we're gone. We have no nation. It's that simple.
It's true, because they've used liberation theology in Mexico for 60 years to make opposition to the PRI and to the other parties communism. And so we got a bunch of communists coming up here who mean well, but are totally, and then they got the Pope manipulating them. I mean, it is a disaster zone. The communist corporate takeover is here. God bless you, Tom. I hear you. All right, Jeannie, Francis. Speaking of Pope Francis, bunch of more callers straight ahead. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. By the way, they found one of the clips, not the one I saw. I saw Hagee like 8, 9 years ago, maybe 10 years ago. It was like 2003, 4. I'm sitting there one day watching television, and I go, oh, it's Pastor Hagee. He gives some interesting speeches. Let me watch him. And I turn it on, and he's up there going, Christ was not the Messiah, but a rebel against the Jewish faith and had to be dealt with, and he was. Defense of Israel. You will learn the real Messiah will soon come. And I was just like, is this Satan speaking? I mean, this is what the Bible says the devil will say. But they did find the little plug where he says something similar, plugging the book in defense of Israel. So now if you don't support Israel, you don't support Israel if you think Jesus is the Messiah. And that's saying that everybody in Israel doesn't think Jesus is the Messiah. So that's just Hagee becoming so enamored of whatever party he supports in Israel that he then basically adopts Judaism. And that's what a lot of Christianity has actually become. I mean, we are a Judaic Christian / British common law culture. So people say, I don't want to hear people that hate Israel say, we're not Judeo-Christian. Yeah, we are. Most of our law comes out of the Ten Commandments, the Old Testament, New Testament. But the point is that there's a move by Hagee and others to even remove that out. So I don't care if it's the Pope or Hagee or whatever. If something's diametrically opposed to the Bible, and a two-year-old can tell it is, those people are no longer Christians. In my view, they are excommunicated. I don't care whether you call yourself a Catholic or whether you call yourself a Protestant. You are not in the body of Christ when you say Christ is not the Messiah. Doesn't take a smart guy to know that, does it? So they say they found one of the clips. Here it is.
Defense of Israel will shape Christian theology. It scripturally proves that the Jewish people as a whole did not reject Jesus as Messiah. It will also prove that Jesus did not come to earth to be the Messiah. It will prove that there was a Calvary conspiracy between Rome, the high priest, and Herod to execute Jesus as an insurrectionist too dangerous to live. Since Jesus refused by word and deed to claim to be the Messiah, how can the Jews be blamed for rejecting what was never offered? Read it in this shocking expose.
Yeah, that's nothing compared to his actual sermon.
This latest book by Pastor...
But again, they said, are you the Messiah? And Christ said, I am. And the high priest ripped his gown off. Went, ah! I mean, anybody that knows the Bible, are you the Messiah? I am he. Ah! Kill him! I mean, the little red tail sticking out from behind Hagee there. We're going to go to break and jam in a few people in overdrive. Jeannie, Francis, and at least Anthony. I don't know about Adam and Chad, sorry. But I've got a lot of calls in. I think I got like 20-something, so that's better than I thought I would. Briefly, I'm not judging Hagee or the Pope. I'm just saying what they're saying is diametrically opposed to the Bible. And this is what churches have become, is where I hear the most demonic preaching out there is from the pulpit. Of course, if you're the devil wanted to take over, where would you go? I don't claim to be some goody two-shoes guy. My heart just loves God, loves justice, loves the unborn, loves human freedom and free will. And that's where I stand, and I believe God's with me. And so who can be against us? We need your prayers. Please spread the word about the broadcast to friends and family. We support ourselves here at InfoWars with high-quality products at low prices, free shipping during the month of July. And we did get more of Prostaguard that sold out within a month of when it came in. It's been 3 months, 2 months since we had it. The best formula, in my view, with, 10 different ingredients, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, my memory was right. 10 ingredients, high quality, known to help your body. In my view, good for women as well. We're selling out of Super Male and Super Female. It could be months till we get that. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. But the key is spread the word about the transmission. Some overdrive coming up. The video just went up on InfoWars.com of our breakdown over an hour ago. Greece, this is a coup. Banksters see sovereignty and assets. Retweet it, please. Greece, # this is a coup. David Knight and I break it down. It is a huge deal. More on that tonight. Nightly News, 7 o'clock Central. Jeannie in Minnesota, thanks for holding. You're on the air.
Hi, Alex.
Welcome.
I've been a member for, I don't know, a little under 10 years.
What, a Prison Planet? A PrisonPlanet.tv? Well, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. All I hear is more proof that this is coming.
Yes.
The one person you had on was Joel Skousen about strategic relocation. I've done that. We have a lake cabin in the middle of North Dakota.
Well, I wish I did.
It's about 100 miles east of the Bakken oil fields. So we're really out there in the middle of North. So I have not heard, you know, the globalists have this blueprint that they're following, and they're going to carry through with it. What I want to know, how can we create a blueprint to survive?
Well, that's it. I mean, I guess I've got to do it. Come up with a plan. First is communication, knowing who the enemy is, what their plan is, warning people that, hey, all this other stuff is noise. Here's their admissions. and then a plan to try to stop it, but also with a fallback plan B to protect ourselves. And I'm so busy just trying to warn people and trying to run this little operation. I basically haven't really prepared myself that much. I mean, I'm trying to. It's overwhelming, and I know why people are overwhelmed. I just don't know what we do. I just wish the general public would wake up out of their trance. But even if you do, they just have a coup over your government. I mean, believe me, if they put Rand Paul in, he's sort of trying to reverse this stuff, they just kill him. And I'm not saying give up hope. It's just that we have to realize that this is life and death. And people that are fighting this need to be supported and prayed for. And I'm not asking for any type of special thanks. I'm asking for people's prayers, because it's very ominous to be in my position, I will tell you. It's not fun to mess with these people, but at my gut level, at a spiritual level, I have to do it. And that's why I get aggressive. It's why I come off as arrogant. And it's really just somebody that's just already resigned to it all, and then I'm going to go follow this road no matter what. And I get a little bit obnoxious whistling past the graveyard just because, as a man, that's what you do. At least that's how I cope, is just make a big sick joke out of it all. But at the same time, my heart is very soft towards innocence. And I just can't believe how bad it already is for most of the world. And to know the judgment our country's coming into, Jeannie, is very sickening.
Yeah, we already have Homeland Security here in Rochester, Minnesota, home of the Mayo Clinic. I've been scoped out by them a couple times.
Oh, yeah.
They were all in flak and armed to the teeth. But are we going to wait until it's too late to do something, to figure out what we should be doing?
Well, here's the problem. Violence won't do anything, because they're already set up for that. They want their minions to get killed to make them martyrs to then demonize us. They're going to kill their own minions and blame it on us. So violence isn't the way to go offensively. We have to credit our own media. We have to discredit the globalists, which has happened. And we have to then withdraw consent from them and stop complying with whatever we can do, whatever God touches our heart to do. I think that's the answer. I think everybody should hit their knees every day for at least 10 minutes and just say, God, I'm opening my mind up. You tell me what to do. And I'm telling you, the answer to what you're supposed to do will come to you. This is why you hit your knees and you say, hey, I'm facing an evil intellect of Satan. I want to be good. You're going to have to take me over. And that'll happen. But God, the devil will take you over without free will. You got to ask God in, and you got to be part of God's plan and be a vessel that God wants to inhabit. And so I'd ask God to come into your heart. I'm sure you've already done that.